वेलकम बैक इन सीरीज ऑफ लेक्चर्स बिल्डिंग प्लानिंग एंड डिजाइन. ओके, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव फिनिश्ड यूनिट नंबर 3 एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट यूनिट नंबर 4, दैट इज बिल्डिंग परमिशंस एंड इट्स अ प्रोसीजर. ओके, फॉलोइंग आर द कंटेंट इन यूनिट नंबर 4, प्रोसीजर and list of document for building permission and significance of various certificates. In that, we have to concentrate on commencement certificate, plinth completion certificate, and occupancy certificate. Okay, here, whenever you are going to start any construction work or you are going to planning to construct any building or a structure, then firstly you have to go for the preparation of the plan in accordance with the owner's requirement. Okay, whatever owner's requirement are there, by considering those owner's requirement, you have to go for the preparation of the plan. Okay, firstly line plan, and then after that detailed sketch plan. Okay, whatever plan you are going to implement at that particular site, okay, that plan should be approved from the local authority. Maybe in that local authority, Jilla Parishad will be there, Tehsil will be there, okay, or whatever Nagar Parishad is there, or municipal corporation is there, or generally in metropolitan cities, okay, corporations are there. From them, we have to take approval for the construction. Or whatever prepared plan, for that plan we have to take the proper permission or approval from them for the implementation of the same thing at that particular site. Okay, so for that purpose you have to prepare municipal building permission drawing. Okay, what you have to prepare? Municipal building permission drawing you have to prepare. In that, I think already we have discussed about what things should be mentioned in that particular sheet, okay, or whatever drawing is there. In that drawing, you have to mention ground floor plan, then after that first floor plan, whatever number of floors are there, you have to draw in that drawing sheet. Okay, or here, if you are going to plan alternate floors, same plan if you are going to implement, okay, then you have to draw a plan for alternate floors, means maybe for 1, 3, 5, then after that 2, 4, 6, in that way. Okay, only two plans you have to draw it for 1, 3, 5 floors and so on, and then after that 2, 4, 6 floors and so on. Okay, for them, or if you are going to plan different things, okay, at different floors, then you have to draw separate detailed sketch plan for each and every floor. Okay, I think all of you understood that thing. Then in that drawing sheet, along with the detailed sketch plans, you have to draw the elevation, as well as in that section should be there. Okay, then after that you have to provide, or you have to mention the site plan also in that drawing, as well as a key plan, or we can say layout plan. Okay, that also you have to mention in that municipal permission building drawing. Then after that you have to provide one title, title block also, okay, in that who is owner, then after that who is the engineer, in that drawing number and all those things, or whatever revisions are there of the drawings, okay, that you have to mention it. As well as you have to show the north direction, and you have to provide one note also, that is whatever dimensions are you are using for which unit you are going to use, means all dimensions are in mm, all dimensions are in meter or centimeter. In that way you have to write one note. Okay, also you have to show the NTS, north to surrounding. Okay, whatever plot is there, according to that, wherever in which direction north direction is there, you have to mention it. Okay, then after that you have to provide door window schedule also in that drawing. Okay, then after that you have to write pro forma 1. Okay, we are going to see what is in the pro forma 1, what which things we have to include in that pro forma 1 and all those things, as well as you have to provide the area statement also, means at ground floor whatever total plot size is there, its length, its width, then after that how much area you are going to build at a ground floor, then after that first floor, second floor, third floor and all those things. And then after that you have to go for the determining the FSI and all those things. Okay, means whatever permissible FSI is there in that particular region also you have to mention in that area statement. Okay, and how much you are going to use FSI in the for the planned building. Okay, that also you have to mention it. Okay, during the practical session I will try to show all those things, okay, in a one sheet. Okay, so you will be understand. So here after drawing municipal building permission drawing, you have to make one application to the local authority for getting approval that plan. Okay, then along with that application, that drawing you have to attach, and whatever required documents are there, maybe Satbara extracts. Okay, then after that property card, then after that various receipts of paid the fees or paid the taxes, whatever applied by the municipal corporation and all those things, those things you have to submit in a bunch to the authority. Okay, after verifying and after satisfaction of that authority, they will permit or they will issue permission later for the implementation of the same plan, or if any variation is there, or is there any changes are there, okay, then they will tell to us you have to make these changes because of whatever you have prepared a plan which is not according to the building bylaws. Okay, means whatever building bylaws or whatever rules and regulations are there in that particular locality, according to that you have not prepared a plan, so that plan will get refused. Okay, means or some for revision purpose they will provide one document also. Okay, then according to their suggestions you have to prepare new plan, and then after that you have to submit it. Okay, after getting the approval you can go for the implement that plan at a site. Okay, but here before going to after getting the approval directly you can't implement that plan. Okay, means before going to start to the construction we should have permission from the local authority. Okay, or whatever municipal commissioner is there, from them we have to take the prior permission for the implementation or to start the work. Okay, whatever certificate we are getting, that is nothing but the commencement certificate. Okay, very first certificate we are getting, that is nothing but the commencement certificate. Once it is obtained, once it is get to you, then you can start the construction work at a actual site. Means maybe firstly you can go for the line out, then after that excavation, and after excavation, then after that construction of the footings and beams and columns up to the plinth level. ओके जोता लेवल पर्यंत तुम्ही काय करू शकता, कंस्ट्रक्शन करू शकता. ओके आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ द कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्क अप टू प्लिंथ लेवल, देन यू हैव टू इंटिमेट, यू हैव टू गिव वन एप्लीकेशन टू द लोकल अथॉरिटी दैट यू हैव कंप्लीटेड युअर कंस्ट्रक्शन वर्क अप टू द प्लिंथ लेवल. सो दे विल परमिट to us whatever remaining construction work is there. For that they will provide one certificate. Okay, that is nothing but the plinth completion certificate. Okay, when you will get that plinth completion certificate, whatever authorities are there or its a team is there, that team will visit to our site. Okay, means whatever construction we have done, whether it is as per the approved plan, sanctioned plan, or whatever specifications are mentioned in the agreement, whether you have followed these specifications and all those things, or according to that only you have used a grade of concrete or quality of steel, maybe in that Fe 415 or Fe 500. Okay, after verifying it, okay, and after getting satisfaction, they will issue the plinth completion certificate. Okay, after getting the plinth completion certificate, you can start the remaining work. Okay, then after that, number of partial completion certificates will be there, or completion certificate will be there. Okay, means it depends upon the rules and regulations of that particular municipal corporation, okay, or whatever jilla parishad and all those things. But generally, if we take loan from bank, okay, then in that case, to releasing the number of whatever loan amount is sanctioned, that amount will not be released to the owner at a time. Okay, but it will be released step by step. Means firstly, at initial, before commencement of the work, they will release some amount. Then after that, after completion of the plinth completion, after getting the plinth completion certificate, they will release second installment. Then after that, third, fourth. In that way, they are going to release the total loan amount. Okay, so for that purpose also, how many installments are there in your agreement, according to that you have to go for the obtaining the completion certificate, partial completion certificate or completion certificate. Okay, means you have to do this application to the local authority that we have constructed up to this and following are the documents are attached, or what here documents, required documents are attached with the application, and then you have to submit it towards the local authority. Okay, then after that they will provide the partially completion certificate or then a completion certificate. Okay, after getting the completion certificate, means after completion of the total construction work, you have to intimate to the authority that is whatever work done is whatever construction work is there, it is now over, so we want a completion certificate. Okay, then same thing will be there. They will visit to our site, then after that they will check everything. If any kind of deviation is there, then they will charge the fees for deviation. Suppose deviation is up to the 5%, then whatever standard charges are there, they will charge to us. Okay, and then whatever owner is there, that he has to pay that deviation charges. If is there any deviation as compared to the अप्रूव्ड प्लान जर जे काय आपल्याला अप्रूव्ड प्लान प्रमाणे जे काही कंस्ट्रक्शन करायचं होतं त्याच्यामध्ये जर काही थोडंफार डिव्हिएशन झालं असेल म्हणजे रूमच्या साईजेस वगैरे जर काही चेंज झालेले असतील किंवा आपण छज्जा जो आहे किंवा आपला जर काही बाल्कनी आहे त्याची विड्थ जी आहे ती थोडीफार जास्त झालेली असेल वगैरे किंवा FSI आहे तो FSI थोडाफार चेंज झालेला असेल तर त्या गोष्टी ज्या आहेत त्याला काय म्हणतोय आपण डेव्हिएशन म्हणतोय. ओके, आपल्या अप्रूव्ड प्लॅनमध्ये आणि आता करंटला जे काही कन्स्ट्रक्शन केलं आहे ॲक्च्युअलमध्ये त्याच्यामध्ये काय आहे तर तफावत जाणवते. त्या तफावतीसाठी आपल्याला काय केलं जातं तर फाईन चार्ज केला जातो आणि तो फाईन आपल्याला काय करायला लागतोय तर पेड करायला लागतोय. आफ्टर पेईंग दॅट फाईन यू विल गेट दी कम्प्लिशन सर्टिफिकेट. ओके, after getting the completion certificate or after completion of the construction work you have to again apply for the occupancy certificate. Okay, means here after completion of the construction work before 30 days your application should reach to the concerned local authority, okay, for getting the occupancy certificate. Okay, then after visiting to the site and after getting the NOCs from various departments and all those things that authority will provide us occupancy certificate. Okay, and then we can occupy that building, okay, for staying purpose or for any other purpose. So this is the step by step procedure. Okay, this is the overview. I told you when we are getting the commencement certificate, plinth completion certificate, completion certificate and occupancy certificate. Okay, so now we are going to discuss in a detail what is mean by commencement certificate, what is it, what is its importance, which documents are required, okay, and what is the format for doing the application to the concerned municipal commissioner or municipal authority and all those things. Okay, now we are going to discuss about the requirements accompanied with the plan. Okay, means whatever plan you have prepared, okay, along with that what things you have to provide or you have to enclose we are going to see now. Okay, first thing is ownership title and area. Here every application for development permission and commencement certificate shall be accompanied with the following documents for verifying the ownership and area etc of the land. Okay, means to getting the permission for the development, okay, and commencement certificate, whatever following documents are there we have to attach it. Okay, first thing is there, that is attested copy of original registered sale, oblique lease, deed, power of attorney enabling ownership and documents whatever applicable. Okay, means here whatever registered document is there, it's a attested copy you have to attach along with that the application. Then after that the Satbara extract 7/12 extract or property registered card of the date not later than 6 months of the date of the submission and a certified copy of the measurement plan of the property under development proposal. Okay, here whatever 7/12 extract is there or whatever property registered card is there you have to attach it and that 7/12 extract should not be issued more than 6 months. Okay, so you have to take due care, otherwise you have to take it from your talati office. Okay, then after that statement of area of the holding by triangulation method from the qualified licensed technical person or architect with an affidavit form the owner in regard to the area in the form prescribed by the commissioner. Whatever prescribed form is available which is on municipal corporation office. Okay, in that you have to go for the affidavit. Okay, regarding the area statement and all those things from the qualified licensed technical person. Okay, and is there any additional documents are required by the order of commissioner, municipal commissioner, and all those things? Then you have to attach it. Okay. Wherever third party interest is created by the way of agreement to sell or mortgage, etc., the registered consent of such interested person shall be submitted to the application with the application. Here, suppose after 1 minute you have to rejoin the session. Okay, after rejoining we will discuss that part.